and he is oh so clever with his fist. Jimmy Young into the ring. George Foreman, that's Gil Clancy. George Foreman laughing, smiling, confident. We'll be back in a moment. 28 years of age. The weight, 229. The record, 45-1. 42 victories by KO. Again, only one loss in the career, and that to Muhammad Ali. The opponent, of course, Jimmy Young, 27, 213 pounds. The record, 20 wins, 5 losses, 2 draws. He scored only 7 KOs. He is not a knockout puncher. He relies on his boxing skills, his ability to counterpunch, his quickness with his head and slipping punches, his quickness with his feet, and using ring size. And in this fight, ring size could be a factor. It is a huge ring, 21 feet. With a thin canvas, which makes for a fast track and gives a good boxer all the room in the world to navigate. The fighters will be fighting this one with 10-ounce gloves. They are heavyweights. They follow the policy here of the state of California, which after a boxing investigation some years ago decided that heavyweights should wear 10-ounce gloves for the safety of the fighters themselves. Scoring is on a 10-point must system. Scoring done by a referee and 2 judges. The mandatory 8-count, of course. The 3 knockdown rule in effect, no saving by the bell. Those are the basics. The referee is Waldemar Schmidt. He's a veteran. He's done many title fights. I'll tell you more about him later. The judges are George in the red trunks, Jimmy in the black trunks. Black and white, Jimmy in the dark trunks, George in the light trunks. Bouts underway. Quick left jab. His reach will surprise you. It is as long, maybe a half inch longer than George's. Immediately, Young registers a complaint to Waldemar Schmidt about dirty tactics. One writer had a whole story about George training with dirty tactics. Makes good copy. We'll have to see what George does in the ring. First round action. Young's task, not to get careless, not to get impatient. There's that quick left jab of George's. Even when it doesn't look like much, ask the man who's hit by it. It's like a lamppost, a pistol. And he's staying away, flicking the left jab. Said earlier, views his task is to be in too close or out too far. Too close to be hurt by way of tying Foreman up, out too far to be hit by Foreman. Foreman comes right at the opponent, or slightly to the opponent's right, anticipating movement in that direction. In that way, he seeks to cut the ring in half and take advantage of a faster opponent, which Young is. 1 minute left in the first round. Clearly a tactical round. Feeling out process. Left in the round. Physically, Foreman looks huge, and yet he's never been more trim. He looks so much bigger than Young, you wonder, can Jimmy be a heavyweight? Young taunting Foreman, talking to him. We approach the end of round one. George Foreman, the red or the light trunks. Jimmy Young, the black or the dark trunks. The first round, a tactical round, as I said. It has often been said, it has often been written, that there is nothing more subjective than the scoring of a fight. Chris and I will keep you abreast of our view of the scoring as we fight, it's very difficult to score a fight involving Jimmy Young. Because, you see, he fights in the main a defensive fight, very cleverly, using the counterpunch. However, against Ali, he didn't have the one-punch knockout fighter to worry about. He has that now with Foreman. Time that Waldemar Schmidt has cautioned George Foreman. It's not like Olympic or amateur boxing, however, where a fighter will be penalized and lose points in the scoring of a round. Scoring on a 10-point must system.
He pushes, man!
With the right after a Foreman lead with the left. Left to drop. Young tucked it right in. Off on Young. Chief response from the crowd to this fight thus far has been to boo Foreman based upon the referee Waldemar Schmidt's remonstrances to George. Now George tried to get in quick. He had a left lead and only grazed. Young complaining to Schmidt about the way Foreman was manhandling, brawling with him. Countdown for the second round in your lower right hand corner. Young with a good right against Foreman's hand. Foreman instantly enraged, went after Young. Jimmy Young, always a surprise, at least in every fight we've covered, but well up in the 90s at the very least. The fight is already filled with sweat. First two rounds, I think the principal focus would have to be on George Foreman's clear attempts to manhandle Jimmy Young the way he did Joe Frazier. However, it's been the tactic of the Young camp to emphasize this before the fight.
So,
corner, the Young corner keeps telling Jimmy, stay away, stick and move, and keeps telling referee Waldemar Schmidt, watch out for Foreman's tactics. Not
move it.
Using tactics that are not entirely reputable is for you, the viewers, to judge. What he's been doing thus far is not very different from what any veteran fighter will do. Because it's not a pretty business. Third round action. Foreman always the pursuer. Nothing there. Screams from the corner, and the crowd reacts. Wait a minute. He took away a point from George Foreman. I didn't realize they had that rule in effect here, very candidly, in Puerto Rico, but he told each judge to take away a point from George Foreman. Frankly, I couldn't see the basis for that. Remember in the Landover fight how Jimmy Young would lean his head through the ropes and out of the ring. Nobody penalized him for that. It's one of the reasons we told you it's so hard to score a fight involving Jimmy Young. But obviously, Young and his people have the official leaning very heavily in his favor in terms of any attempts to muscle Young by Foreman. Third round action. Good left lead by Young. Another left lead by Young. Foreman looking purposeful. Thus far, and this is the third round, has thus far been unable able to get to Young. Again, Waldemar Schmidt cautioning Foreman. Young at every turn finds cause to complain about Foreman's tactics. And the crowd is reacting in Young's favor. We're almost at the end of round three.
3, 2, 1, go ahead.
Jimmy Young in the black or dark trunks coming out to face George Foreman in the red or light trunks. Teresa, it has been totally a tactical fight thus far. The action is Young's plan, obvious, to get Foreman to lose emotional control of himself, to enrage him. And so at every turn, he is looking to the referee, Waldemar Schmidt, to complain about manhandling, brawling action. Right there, you saw another evidence. And quickly, Schmidt responds, telling Foreman, who was penalized to fight in one round, that he must cease and desist. Debris just thrown across the ring, right into this reporter's hand. Always had the good hands. But that's the set up till now. Young fighting his kind of fight, defensive and occasional counter punch. Foreman's job to control himself. So difficult to score a Jimmy Young fight. But in these first three rounds, I'd have to give Jimmy Young a slight edge, wouldn't you, Chris?
Busy, busy left hand.
Yes, I certainly would.
Busy left hand.
It just seems like Joe Louis used to say, you can run, but you can't hide. And that appears to what's happening right now. And Foreman is so strong.
He is a huge man. He makes Young seem like a light heavyweight by comparison. But his problem is well known, based upon his boxing history. Stamina. Young has said if he's not hurt in the first five rounds, and I've mentioned this earlier, he will win the fight. Once again, as Foreman pushes Young off, in half disgust, Waldemar Schmidt cautions Foreman. George, with a left to the head, tried to come into the belly. But it was picked off, basically, by Young's glove. He's got such quick hands for defense. If there's a style to trouble Foreman, Jimmy Young has it. Many of us used to wonder why the late Yancey Durham ever gave George Foreman a shot at Joe Frazier in Kingston, Jamaica. He couldn't understand it. His Frazier style was so right for Foreman. Young's style is now puzzling Foreman. George Foreman's face, he was just badgering A with his corner, B with some fans. The very thing from his point of view he must not do. We are coming to you live via the satellite from Roberto Clemente Coliseum. Scheduled 12 round of fifth round. Foreman against Young. Thus far, Young fighting his curious defensive style of fighting is clearly troubling Foreman. You know, Chris, they said Foreman had to punch shorter, and so he did against Frazier. But Frazier doesn't have the quick hands that Jimmy Young does. And therefore, Foreman doesn't have to keep his gloves in punching position so constantly against a Frazier as he does against a Young. And he is not keeping his gloves steadily in punching position. Have you noticed?
Certainly noticed it. And there have been thud punches to the body that just happened there. Not really telling blows, because George very often hits with an open glove.
Ali said after the fifth round there was nothing left in Foreman's punches. Young said, as I noted 2 days ago, if I'm not hurt by the fifth round, it's over for Foreman. However, words are idle things. Let's see what happens in the ring. have reason to tell you otherwise. This is to notify our stations along the line that we are coming up with a station break. Fifth round action. Foreman to the left of your screen, Young to the right. With a patch of gray in his head. But clearly it hasn't been from pre-fight worry. The two fighters have had one key common opponent, Ron Lyle. Twice, Jimmy Young boxed Lyle to a bare knee. Tied him up inside and fought more offensively because of his total confidence against Lyle when he's fighting tonight. Once Foreman fought Lyle, that Las Vegas, Nevada, at Caesars Palace. Foreman was decked twice by Lyle, but came back to knock Lyle out in the fifth round. Coming up the end of the round, we'll return after this from our local station. Underway. Up till now, a dull fight. For the average viewer, much too tactical. Foreman unable thus far to get on track. Young now, coming into the sixth round, looking more sprightly on his feet. Look at the foot movement.
Damn it.
Young trying to get to him with the jab, but Foreman always the pursuer. Foreman there, attempting to go to the midsection. Might be a tendency here, Chris, for Young, having survived five rounds, to become a little more aggressive. In Young's corner, they were very confident between rounds that Jimmy is ahead. And they have Jimmy fighting the kind of fight that they want him to fight.
And now off to the right, they can hear his corner asking him to jab.
See that left thrown by Foreman. It was a kind of cuffing thing, and that too, with a half-open glove.
Right.
Not reflecting the power of Foreman, really. Gil Clancy over in the opposite corner, looking up, and he is noticeably concerned. Round action.
I don't think he can look for the one punch like Alfredo Escalera did against Ronnie McGarvey, ending it in the sixth round. The one punch, he's got to get some combinations here.
Well, I'm not sure I agree with that, Chris. Not with the way Foreman can punch, but he's got to land.
He's a pretty good defensive fighter.
Let free by the referee. He lunged in at Young, and Young is a master at slipping punches and picking punches with his gloves, came back with his own counter.
Ooh, now that's flagrant right there. Yet we should remind viewers, Howard, that the last thing a referee says, protect yourself at all times. So
Jimmy Young, in this round, has been just a touch more aggressive. Right there, with the right. Counting down to the end of round six. A curious fight. Involving Jimmy Young, that's difficult to score, difficult to decipher. Foreman has been pursuing, but he's never gotten on track. He's been all tied up by Jimmy Young. Right there, Young was hurt. Right there, Young was hurt by a Foreman left. Now he's in trouble. Suddenly, Foreman connected. Young is in trouble. He's going to have to draw on every boxing skill to survive. It happened with a quick jolting left. That's what I meant, Chris. The power of Foreman is amazing. Professional poison can finish it. Seventh round action. Jimmy
punches being thrown.
How overconfident Young's corner was between rounds. They told us no contest, but suddenly Foreman struck. And so, for the first time in his career, Foreman shows a surgeon's power in a later round of a fight.
But he should be smarter
not
now.
Holding
he should
on.
Wait. He should Foreman wait and set
him
up.
Foreman is not keeping his professional voice.
No, not at all. Minute and a half to go in the round.
Should measure, pick his opportunities, capitalize, but he's not doing it. He's been frustrated for six rounds, and suddenly he realized he had the opponent. Calling him now. A left and a right. Young holding on. Still Foreman can't put him away. Hasn't even sent him to the canvas. 21-foot ring to negotiate in. Young going from rope on one side to rope. Of the round. 35 seconds left. Getting light. Look at Young fight back. You see that right? Get into Foreman. Foreman arms grow legend. Young, a courageous fighter, filled with boxing skills. The crowd on its feet. Young was apparently gone, but far from it now. If you wanted to know about Jimmy Young's heart, you found out about it this round.
And what condition he's in.
Jimmy Young survives the round. He survives the round and comes back fighting. I wish we could show you this crowd on its feet, giving a standing ovation to Jimmy Young. Now in slow motion, let's look at what Foreman does here. Seventh round action. Now watch this. There's the left. That's the piston-like left. It comes in the way Liston's used to, Chris, like a lamppost. And there was Young, wavering, waffling about the ring. But Foreman couldn't capitalize. A testing round. But Jimmy Young, a round that showed the courage of the fighter and the skills of the fighter. Foreman, a testing round two, but one that has to leave you with a negative impression because George couldn't put him away. This crowd now chanting, eighth round bell, action coming up. Foreman now knows how he can hurt you. That much you must say. And Young now knows how Foreman can hurt him. But Young knows he can survive. And Young tries to assume the aggressor's role. Look at that right. Now he's going at George Foreman. Change of tactics, at least in the early seconds of round eight. This is the kind of fight we were expecting, hoping for. Crowd chanting, Jimmy Young. Jimmy Young, Jimmy Young. Clearly the favorite of the crowd. That's one of the things that so emotionally disturbed Foreman his whole career. What, he kept saying to himself, do I have to do to be a crowd pleaser? Why won't they give me their cheers? Eighth round action. Schmidt, the third man in the ring. That 21-foot ring didn't hurt Jimmy Young a bit. The last round, Chris, not one bit.
Use it all. He's been doing it.
George Foreman, wanting so desperately to put Young away. Young continues, unafraid, unmarked for that matter. Come on, as he had in the seventh. 10 seconds left. You see it in the lower right-hand corner. Counting down. We're going to stay with these fights. Wild swing by George. The end of the round. It has gone 8 rounds. Under any circumstances, let's again look at slow motion action. Let's look at Jimmy Young getting in a right and a left. This will be a closely scored fight, we think. There's the left. The right was earlier. You saw it in slow motion. Then Young tying up Foreman. He's so effective at that. This fight, Chris, is going to be very difficult to score. Jack Levin over in Jimmy Young's corner just asked him, how are you scoring? How do you see it? So they're beginning to get worried. George took the seventh round, and it looked like he was going to take the fight, but he couldn't do it. How do you have it scored, Chris?
I have Young ahead because in my book, he took the last 2 rounds.
Ninth round action. George ever pursuing, as you can see. Note the way Young covers up with those gloves in front of the face. He's a master at that. Right above us now, the sweat of the fighters pouring down on us, reminiscent of a brilliant Bob Considine description of the past when he was at ringside. Jimmy Young had a quick flurry there. Foreman looking for the kind of opening that he got suddenly from nowhere in the seventh round. But having so much trouble, you see Young covering up. Foreman hitting the fighter's gloves, the fighter's elbows. But Foreman, not really, hitting Jimmy Young any place where he's vulnerable. Look at Young fight back, counterpunch. Waldemar Schmidt breaks the fighters. The crowd held right there that Foreman. He must stay either in too close or out too far. He must, from his point of view. From George Foreman's point of view, he must use those fists, keep them in punching position, which against a fighter as quick as Jimmy Young, he has not been doing. Ninth round action.
If he can keep this up, even though only 29 fights, he's lasted 10 rounds 7 times, once 15 with Muhammad Ali.
He has, as I have said on a number of occasions, Christopher, the Philadelphia smarts. Not the Philadelphia punch, but the cleverness. Good left by Jimmy Young. Ask for a more masterful exhibition than he gave in the seventh round when Foreman had him ready to go. How he collected himself, held together, and wound up on the attack. The end of the round coming up. Tenth round, remember, this is a scheduled 12 rounder. This is not a final round, just the 10th round. And what an interesting turn this fight has taken. Jimmy Young using every skill, using the size of the ring, keeping his poise, his self-possession, using his gloves to pick off the opponent's punches. Foreman has not too often had his gloves in punching position. Foreman, sometimes on the verge of losing his own emotional control, quick to anger, thwarted by the referee in the early going when he kept being accused of manhandling. even at one point being penalized a point by the referee. In the score. There was a good left by Foreman. There was a good left. Now Foreman trying to capitalize. Tenth round action. Foreman punching wildly. Not short, direct, and crisp like they've tried to teach him, but reverting back, or so it seems to your reporter. Would have been far more effective earlier on in this fight because it's well known the body blows accumulatively destroy the stamina of the opponent. This is the 10th round of a 12-rounder. It's a little late. You saw how quick Young's hands were to get in there. Quick combination. Now Foreman using the strength of his body where he can. Waldemar Schmidt separating the fight. Number of blows Foreman is throwing from the awkward position he's throwing them from and keep hitting air, empty air, the arm. Ooh, very heavy. Make no mistake about it, Jimmy Young has felt the weight of that body through 9 grueling rounds and misses the 10th. So he's a tired young man. He is a professional, this kid. You saw Jimmy with a wild ride himself. So tired. Over the head of Schmidt, breaking them apart. The crowd booing George Foreman for his falling tactics. We come to the end of the 10th round. 11, and there is puzzlement in the eyes and face of George Foreman. He really believed that he would get to Jimmy Young. And quickly, it has not happened. There's Young with a left lead, scoring. Each fighter closed the 10th round dead tired. I suspect, however, that Foreman is most tired in the arms. He's caught a lot of empty air tonight, and he's caught a lot of Jimmy Young's gloves. He's caught Jimmy Young primarily in the 7th round, when it appeared he could put him away. Ring craftsmanship. Young kept himself together, covered up, stayed away when he had to, and then came back fighting, scoring with counterpunches at the end of the 7th round. Now we're in the 11th. George Foreman has rarely had to go this kind of distance. He got knocked out in the 8th by Ali, as you all know. Twice he had to go 10 against Gregorio. Look at Young working to the midsection as he's in close with Foreman tied up. And then once he went 10 rounds against Levi Fortey. Same spelling as my director, who is one-third of Fortey's size. I refer, of course, to Chet Fortey. Jimmy Young growing in confidence now. Began trying to take the offense in a limited kind of way in the 9th round, having survived what he did in the 7th. Look at him walk away, hands at side. Three times Big George had to go into the 10th round, but I have no present recollection of him ever having to go into the 11th.
All 12,000 standing with a round to go.
They've been this way ever since the 7th round when Young survived.
And it's hot.
Foreman's eyes are bright. But somehow you have to question the legs and arms and the stamina of this man, because he becomes a little bouncy and not quite secure on that canvas as the rounds progress. You have seen for yourself. We approach the end of this round.
Him out to win.
All right. You see George Foreman being spoken to by Gil Clancy, who is really a disturbed man. Look at Clancy's face. Clancy shouting. At this point, he may figure George has to look. There's the left lead by Young, and look at that right. Right in through Foreman's guard. The arms too tired, the hands too tired to cover up. That's what Jimmy Young has been doing in the last three rounds, beginning with the ninth round.
And now hang on. Foreman wants a knockout, and I think he needs it to win.
Well, you know, I've had so many experiences, Chris,
so have I,
with these judges and these officials, that you hesitate to call it. I have Young ahead on my call.
So do I.
12th round action. Young ties Foreman up. Foreman, a tired man now. Almost receptive to it. See the way George is now bouncing on his feet? Now that's not just good foot action.
You can't punch from there either, solidly. Not George Foreman.
12th and final round. Look at Jimmy Young. With combinations. Well, they'll know that Jimmy Young is a fighter after this fight. Somebody said to him at a press conference the other day, a lot of us don't think you've got the heart. He said, what do you know about my heart? Did I do my thing in the ring? And he showed his heart tonight in the seventh round. Listen to the crowd now. They picked up the chant again. Jimmy Young, Jimmy Young, Jimmy Young. Foreman. Yes. Foreman off balance. In a way of the Ali fight. The eighth round. A minute and 50.
He's tired.
Left to go in the fight. Foreman tries again. Slick, slick. No knockdown. Slick.
If that's a knockdown, a knockdown.
He counted it as a knockdown.
Right.
Debris pouring into the ring. Foreman, desperation registered in his face.
Less than a minute, Howard.
50 seconds left to go. Jimmy Young doing his thing. Still thought it was a slip, Christopher. I didn't see a clean blow. Referee saw it as a knockdown. So the eighth. Look at Young. Foreman with a half minute left. Foreman holding on around the neck. George has 15 seconds left and he appears to be in no condition to do anything. He is lumbering.
He's looking at the clock. Too late. 5 seconds.
This fight is over. And look at that crowd get to its feet. Look at Jimmy Young right above us at ringside, waving his arms aloft in what he feels is certain victory. You talk about figuring out how to fight an opponent. You talk about going into a fight with a fight plan. That's what Jimmy Young did tonight, and he made it stick from beginning to end. I'll go on record right now, Christopher. I think Jimmy Young cleanly won this fight. We'll be right back with the decision.
And here we are.
are in that 12th and final round. George Foreman on the left and Jimmy Young on the right. That little left hand off balance, and then her high right glancing off the forehead. And now see if there was, well, there wasn't a little bit of a shove, but he did go down. His gloves touched the canvas, and we checked with Ismael Fernandez, one of the judges, a moment ago, and it is scored as a knockdown. Now we have to listen very closely here along with you on the scoring. The referee, Vladimir Schmidt, worldwide in reputation. Ismael Fernandez, the judge that Frank Gelb, the manager of Ronnie McGarvey, who lost on a TKO at 203 of the sixth round against the world champion, was the other judge along with Cesar Ramos. As we go to Howard in the ring. Howard?
Back off. All right, Chris, as usual, the bedlam scene. I'm with Jimmy Young, but we're still awaiting the official decision. Jimmy, he wants to talk to George Foreman, understandably, for just a moment. All right. As you can see, I have George and Jimmy both here. We're awaiting the decision. George, first, your comment on the kind of fight Jimmy Young fought.
No comment, Howard.
No comment? Okay. Jimmy, your comment, you made your fight plan stick as you saw it.
Yes. Although I got hurt real bad, I think it was the fifth round. Tell the truth, I didn't really think I was going to make it.
It was the seventh round, Jimmy.
Seventh, see, I don't even remember. I think it was desperation.
Desperation, you say, kept you alive. Here's the decision.
116, 112, Jimmy Young.
Jimmy, just a final word, because you've already told us that desperation enabled you to survive that seventh round. Jimmy Young with a unanimous decision.
All right!
Our congratulations to you.
Jimmy, get down, man!
Jimmy, I don't... Jim, can I have you facing the camera for 1 minute? Jim, what now? You want to get back at Ali.
I'm listening first. Keep him, Rick.
You won,
yes.
Ali.
Oh, somebody's scratching me. Yes, if he wants to fight. If not, or if he doesn't return to the ring, I will fight the other top contenders.